after weeks of tense negotiations and deadly clashes between Indian and Chinese troops, both countries have pulled back into their own sides of the border, creating a buffer zone in between. The Indo-China border sees regular incursions by the Chinese. However, this time things came to a head when soldiers, after a hostile standoff, came to blows, resulting in casualties on both sides. But India of 2020 would not be arm-twisted by the neighbour, not this time. Military talks have resulted in peaceful resolution, at least for the time being. However, there was another India in 1962, barely 20 years since its independence, when its military was ill-equipped to deal with threats from across the border. The degree to which the Indian Army was unprepared is demonstrated by the fact that the soldiers not only did not have weapons to match Chinese capability, but nor did they have proper uniforms or shoes to keep them warm at the high altitudes they were battling in. It is said that the cold caused more damage to the Jawans than the enemy. The 1962 Indo-China War is described in detail in the book Himalayan Blunder, a first-hand account by former Brigadier J.P. Dalvi. He penned his experiences while he was jailed for 7 months as a prisoner of war by the Chinese. In the War of 1962, Brigadier Dalvi was leading the 7th Infantry Brigade, which was responsible for the defense of India's northeast, which included Arunachal Pradesh. On 22nd October, Brigadier John Dalvi's brigade headquarters was attacked. This dealt quite a blow to his brigade. Many Jawans laid down their lives. Despite the odds, Indian soldiers fought bravely and defended Arunachal Pradesh, pushing back the Chinese and thwarting its expansionist claims on the state. However, Brigadier John Dalvi was captured by the Chinese and jailed till the end of war. Brigadier called the war India's most crushing military disaster, and the book was promptly banned. He revealed that Indian soldiers were not adequately prepared in terms of equipment to respond to the Chinese, and despite this, the army was sent to face a far stronger enemy. He records India had weapons from the Second World War era, while the Chinese were armed with AK-47s. Himalayan Blunder was banned in 1962 due to its scathing attack on the Nehru administration. The ban was later lifted, and the book has now become one of the most authentic accounts of the 1962 Indo-China War.